السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. رمضان مبارك، رمضان كريم، وكل عام وأنتم بخير. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Congratulations for making it to the month of Ramadan 1414 after the Hijrah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So we are going to fast for the year number 1437 or 38, 3 years in Medina when fasting was prescribed. My brothers and sisters, pay attention here, ladies. Socializing is over now. Now it is ibadah. Let's focus on this beautiful month of Ramadan. So, I call it the spiritual shower. Spiritual shower. When you go to the shower, you take with you what? Towel. What else? Soap, shampoo, and comb. And of course, there is something we use back home. We call it keys. It's something like a pouch. We use it to remove the dead skin. These days they don't use it. Just rub up water. So you need to remove the dead skin. So think of each one of them as something in life. Dead skin is sins. Dirt, germs, bacteria, sins. Inshallah, minor sins only. We don't have major sins, alhamdulillah. And then shampoo and soap and water. Inshallah, the acts of ibadah, the worship, the service, the iftar, the patience, and all of these good deeds that you do in the month of Ramadan. So every time you do a good deed, you're removing a bad deed. And not only you're removing it, because this is an opportunity. This is the season where you buy 10 for 1, for the price of 1. Or 10 in this Ramadan, 70 for the price of 1. Imagine they tell you, you're going to have 1 pound of meat, the price is 2.99, for that you can get 70 pounds. Just imagine on worldly things. Or you're told, if you pay for 1 car, you get 70 cars. Or you pay for, you know, one ticket to somewhere, for that 70 people can get it. So imagine how much. Wallahu yudha'ifu liman yasha. We are getting into this month of Ramadan. We have just started after Maghrib. Alhamdulillah, the hilal has been seen in many places, and especially here in the Americas. And we are starting our month with the hope and with expectation. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Man sama Ramadana imanan wahtisaba ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi. Whoever fasts with two things, with faith, with iman you believe, but also you expect the reward of Allah, Allah will forgive all your sins. كل ابن آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التوابون. Every son and daughter of Adam is a sinner and the best amongst the sinners are those who make tawbah. So let's start this month by making two du'as. Beautiful for tawbah. Say after me, Astaghfirullah Al-Azim Al-Ladhi La ilaha illa hu Al-Hayy Al-Qayyum Wa atubu ilayh Min kulli dhanbin أذنبته سرا أو علنا علما أو جهلا. And also you say سيد الاستغفار اللهم أنت ربي لا إله إلا أنت خلقتني وأنا عبدك وأنا على عهدك ووعدك ما استطعت. أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت. أقوم لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء لك بذنبي فاغفر لي فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. This dua of istighfar is good, and I want in these few minutes to make a plan with you. We spoke about eating less this month, fasting more than feasting, inshallah. We'll try all of us. Although by Maghrib you go crazy, you just want to eat anything. But we'll try. But I want to talk about Ramadan. The highlight of Ramadan is what? Laylatul Qadr. And how can we, inshallah, not miss Laylatul Qadr this year? I don't want to miss it. Is there anybody here who would like to miss Laylatul Qadr? Nabi Sallallahu says, "Man hurima ajraha faqad hurim." You know, some people unfortunately use cultural things. I have to do Khatmul Quran, and that's it. I'll do it in the first 5 days, so I can relax in the month of Ramadan. In some Muslim countries, Ramadan is for the first week, and the last 10 nights, nobody is there. If that makes sense, they say, "Alhamdulillah, we did Khatmul Quran." No. We increase the qira'ah here in the last 10 nights. We keep you a little bit longer. We make it easy for you here. We just read, you know, less so you can go home and sleep. So we want you to be more focused on the last 10 nights. So we're going to do 3 things this year, inshallah. Do you want to know what are these 3 things? Number one, we know an-Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam promised us that the one who fasts and breaks his fast, when he or she makes dua, the dua is not rejected. Who said that? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inna lis-sa'imi 'inda fitrihi da'watun la turad. Aw fi riwayah, la turad 'inda fitrihi. Inna lis-sa'imi da'watun la turad 'inda fitrihi. For the fasting person, there is a dua that is granted, can never be rejected when he or she breaks the fast. So what are we going to say when we break our fast? Of course, you're going to eat something. If you don't have, you drink water at the earliest time as per the sunnah. And you say, Allahumma laka sumtu wa ala rizqika aftartu wa bika amantu fataqabbal minni. Speak Japanese or Chinese or Urdu, say in your language, Allah accepts. But try to say it in Arabic if you can. If not, Allah understands everything. Because you said that, you can say, Dahaba al-dhama'u wa tallat al-uruqu wa thabat al-ajru, inshaAllah. But immediately after that, say, Allahumma لا تحرمني أجر ليلة القدر وخير ليلة القدر. Say, Ya Allah, do not deprive me from the rewards and the blessings of Laylatul Qadr. Now you're smart. Every night I'm going to ask, and I'm going to be consistent, and I'm going to insist on Allah not to deprive me from Laylatul Qadr. And because the dua is answered at the breaking of the fast, then inshallah we will not miss it. Number two, when the last 10 nights come, when the Ramadan starts, you are going to pray Isha and Fajr in Jama'ah. Isha and Fajr in Jama'ah. Why? An-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, من صلى العشاء في جماعة فكأنما قام نصف الليل ومن صلى الفجر في جماعة فكأنما قام الليل كله. Whoever prays عشاء, I'm not talking about تراويح, عشاء صلاة in جماعة, it will be considered as if he or she prayed half of the night. This is in Ramadan and outside Ramadan. But because he did it in Ramadan, it's a big reward. And whoever prays Fajr in Jama'ah, now Jama'ah could be in the masjid, could be at home. You know, 3 and more. If you can't make it, when you do suhoor, pray together. Fajr, he will be considered as if he prayed up all night. So now, another way not to miss Laylatul Qadr. Third thing, in the last 10 nights, pray at least two rak'ahs before suhoor. The best time of the night is the hour before suhoor. So 3 o'clock, even 3:30, that's the best time of any night, including in Ramadan. Pray two rak'ahs every night, and maybe in the last 10 nights, add two more rak'ahs. And delay witr. If you're sure you're not going to miss witr, delay witr. It's better to pray witr before fajr. Inshallah, this way, you will not miss Laylatul Qadr. Because Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alf shahr. It is far better than 1,000 months. In Arabic, 1,000 doesn't mean 1,000. Means more than what you can imagine. When the Arabs say alf, it doesn't mean 1,000. It means beyond your imagination. Alhamdulillah. With that, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to deprive us from Laylatul Qadr and to make this Ramadan a month of blessing for all of us, and to cover with His mercy those who have died, and to give shifa to those who are sick, and to make it easy for the Muslims all over the world, especially Muslims who are where it's illegal to fast, such as in Angola and in China and many other places where it's illegal to be Muslim. Unfortunately, we hear again this year the plight of our brothers and sisters around the world. May Allah make it easy for those who don't even have food to break their fast, or they have to hide their fasting. May Allah make it easy for everyone. Ameen, ameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa akhir da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. We ask inshaAllah, Hafid Musa, inshaAllah, Hafid Musa, you're going to make the first adhan of Ramadan, inshaAllah.